Good afternoon from SoFi Stadium in Inglewood, California, and welcome to Super Bowl 56.
It's time for all of us here and millions around the world to bear witness to these incredible players who will leave every ounce of sweat, guts, and pride and legacy on this hallowed field, because that is what champions do.
And the swing of the right leg and flat, Super Bowl 56 is underway.
Morocco is a North African country, and what I love about it is the diversity that we have between all the cities. It's full of a lot of flavors, which is amazingly good. But when I was young, it was really hard. We were just us, and we were in one room in a shared apartment. The bare minimum things that my friends had, I couldn't have it. Also, here in Morocco, unfortunately, the women are going to be judged and criticized.
ما كبرتش فيها كاع داكشي ديال انا كنت كنبغي تكون بحال شي بنيته لابسه كسوه وصباط وهادي وكنشري لها دوك الكسيوات كتحيدهم كتلبس سيرفيت. المجتمع ديالنا كان صعيب, كيقول لي البنت ما مزياناش عندك كتلعب مع الاولاد. ملي بدات تكبر غادا تصلي ودير الدره وهادي وصافي وتقرا وتوصل لواحد سميتو صافي وتخدم شي خدمه محترمه تيجي ربي ولد الناس كيتزوجها.
Girls in the city that I'm in, they are expected to be average, to have like a minimum of education in order to help the kids that they will be bringing to life. They think that this is their ultimate mission. They are not expected to be someone like leading a community or be someone important.
It's so different to be a woman here, because everyone believes in men, not in the woman.
I felt like I'm less than a human being. I came across a picture of my classmate on Facebook. She was wearing a helmet and pad. I liked what I saw. I knew about American football because I was studying English at the university. So I asked her, can you take me? I joined their practice and I loved it.
I saw Fouzia in love with the American football, like all her tank in American football. I want to play American football.
But the thing that I didn't like is when the guys started the scrimmage, the girls went to the sideline. So I felt like so bad, and I was waiting for my turn in order to get in the field. But after they huddled up and they were like, oh, it was a nice session. And I was like, is that all? I found it really unfair. I felt like I'm more cheerleader than a football player. I was like, yo, it's either we're gonna play or we're gonna do our own team. They didn't believe that we're gonna do it. So they were like, okay, go. We didn't have any equipments. We didn't have balls. We started playing at the beach. It was really, really hard time, like a real struggle before. Me asking girls to come to practice American football, they thought that I'm insane. Parents, including my mom, didn't think that American football is a good thing for me.
يعني ما كانش عندنا حنا فهاد ما كانش حنا كاع والدينا يتقبلوا وسايبه وهادي وما مزياناش صافي وانا كنبقى نتعصب ونبقى نتصوف.
When I think something is right and I'm not hurting anyone and I'm doing it for the good of the people surrounded by me, why am I gonna stop?
It's been a fight for the rights of women, especially that we are talking about the context of American football. It's one of the last places a woman is supposed to be at if we look at it from a cultural perspective.
Some of them, they've been forced to get married. Some of them, they've been forced to stop school. Some of them, they've been forced to just stay home and do the dishes because they think that the right of playing is not for everyone and it's only for boys.
At first, no one believed in her. Even me, even my mom, no one, because she's a girl. That was so crazy.
We were like just two girls once we started. Then we started posting on social media and people thought, oh, she's doing something. One day I came, I found like 20 girls on the beach because we didn't have a field yet. So I was like super happy and hyped. If this session we have 20, the next one we can have more. And we end up like having the biggest team in Morocco at that time.
To succeed in doing that and having them on practice on our game day with jerseys on, which means that these people are consistent. So I was like, they're on something.
Struggle make you a better person. The people who said no to me, the people who didn't like who I am, where I came from, they gave me the motivation to carry on. But when I got sick, everything stopped. One day, I noticed that I couldn't even walk the stairs. I knew that I wasn't me. I'm an athlete. I can do whatever I want. This is not who I am. So I went to the doctor. They told me I have cancer. Stage 3 breast cancer. I was speechless.
I was shocked and angry and sad. Everything. I had all this emotion. We think she's gonna die.
No, Fouzia. Fouzia? No. صافي
واحد واحد الحاله صافي سلمت امر الله وليت كندعي الله صباح وعشيه ما بقاش عندي الجهد صافي عييت وبنتي مسكينه عيات صافي حتى بنتي مسكينه واحد الوقت بديت كتقول صافي ماما الله يعطيني شي موته مستوره صباره وكتقاوم ومقاوم كتقاوم قاومة المرض قاومة أي حاجة كتجيها قاومة الفقر والمرض وكل شيء كل شيء الله يرضى عليه ويسهل عليه وسمحوا لي إلا بكيت
I was going through chemotherapy I couldn't even walk like for few steps so I knew that it's hard to be the athletic girl that I was before. I always thought that this is not the end. And I always knew that I'm stronger than it. And I can go back to the field. I can do a lot more. And it's not all, I mean, only about playing.
She told us if she survived, she's gonna create her academy and help the girls. All day, all night, she talk about her dream.
Once you accept the fact that this is just a phase, I'm telling myself, this is just a phase. Football is waiting. Let's go. Let's finish this. Growing football, it doesn't mean always to be a professional player. You can impact the game by being outside the field, on the field. And now, since I changed my perspective to American football from a player to an entrepreneur and a coach, I know what I'm gonna do and I know that I can do more than a player now.
When I play American football with my friends, I feel like I'm with my second family. I feel so comfortable and I feel so free.
When I think about the younger version of me, all I see is lack of opportunities. I've been somewhere that I don't want girls that I'm having at the academy to be there.
أنا كنحشم وهنا كنمشي نلعب فوتبول ما كنبقاش نحشم هنا ومشي أنا فايتة صحاباتي ولا هما فايتيني حنا بحال.
What I saw was more than just Coach Fouzia. It was more of Mama Bear on the field. It was more of this, human relationship.
Me seeing them like enjoying and learning, and I know that the future that I couldn't have, they can have it.
Good job. Now it's better. Good job.
This whole experience makes a big difference in me. At first, I was like, I don't know what American football means, but now I'm the captain of my team. I love what I do.
I feel that like this is my mission now. Being able to make that girl came from home and not just staying home and didn't grow up out from school, it's a success for me because I know that I impacted her life. The National Football League reached out to me because they admire what I've been doing here in my community and they wanted to show their appreciation by inviting me to the Super Bowl. I was in shock. I was speechless. Is this happening for real?
We were so happy because this is her dream. She told me, one day I'm gonna go in the Super Bowl. And I said, yes, you will. But now, like she will.
Hi, Miss Lady, how are you?
Hi, Coach Lou, how are you doing?
My goodness, you're in LA for the Super Bowl. That's incredible.
I still like feel like it's not happening somehow, but.
I am like a living example that everybody can achieve what they that's why I'm telling the girls.
Her being there is just huge for Morocco, huge for women. She's actually, you know, just dragging everyone and everything on her back.
Continue to do what you've been doing. You know, football is for everyone. And I think the love of the game is gonna transcend gender and it's gonna transcend possibility. The Buccaneers do want to lend some support to your program, send you some of the things that you might need, equipment and some uniforms. They wanted to also reach out to you and say thank you for all the good work that you've been doing.
Are you gonna make me cry because of that?
I'm doing this for three people. My mom, because I can never be here without her. The girls in the academy, the girls are gonna be forced to get married, gonna drop out of school just to be the perfect girl that the parents think that the girl should be. And the last person that I'm doing this for is the youngest version of me that didn't believe that I can be here today. I'm gonna make that girl proud.